Good morning all. Today we are going to see Software Engineering 4th unit. The topic is Testing Strategy. First topic is Strategic Approach. In order to perform effective testing, we need to conduct effective technical reviews, what is called as a review. Before going for our testing, we need to do a review kind of meeting. What is called as a review kind of meeting? We need to check whether the code passes the correct requirement or not. Okay, we can have number of techniques are there for performing review, that is test checking, walkthroughs and inspections. Second point is testing will always begin at the component level and move towards the integration of the entire component. Next one is for this we can have different testing techniques have been available at different points of time. We can have two types of activities. One is testing activity. Next one is debugging activity. Testing activity is being done by the tester. And debugging activities is being done by the developer. That is, they need to follow some kind of steps. They need to first of all locate the defects where the defect comes. Next is they need to repair the code, then retest the code. These are the four steps needs to be followed in the debugging activity. So first approach is VNV. What is called as a VNV? Verification and validation. Verifications refers to a set of software tasks that ensure whether the product implements correctly. Validation refers to a different set of tasks that ensure whether the software product has been built according to the customer requirement. That is, verification means static testing, validation means dynamic testing. Verification always ensures whether the documents in the requirement phase, design phase, coding and testing are being correct to the specification given. Next one is methods used in the verification are reviews, walkthroughs, inspections and also the verification means it does not involve the execution of the program. In validation, it involves the execution of the program. And methods used in the validation are black box testing, white box testing, and other non-functional testing as well. And in validation, we'll be validating the actual product with the expected product. In verification, we can say, are we building the product right in each of the phase of the software lifecycle? In validation, we can say, are we building the right product? Next approach is we just want to decide who does the testing, whether it is a developer or an independent tester. For small project, we can say developer itself acts as a tester, then they will be proceeding with the testing. But as a developer, when he or she will do the testing, definitely they will test it, test the software product to be a defect-free, then they will deliver it in a corresponding schedule and also in the budget. They will not consider about the other things. But when in the case of the independent tester, they will learn about the system, they will somehow break the software product, then definitely they will come with the some of the defects are there to the developer. They will be driven by the quality. Next is the important concept is the testing strategy. Here it is being given in the spiral form. First of all, it will start with the system engineering in the lower level. That is the outward spiral. Here, they will be specifying the role of the software, for what purpose the software is being intended. Then we need to gather our requirements for developing the software. Then goes to the design phase. Then goes to the coding phase. So, the activities, it will be involved from the outward towards the inward in the spiral form. What about the testing activity? Testing activity will be involved from the inwards towards the outwards. That is, in the coding phase, we'll be doing the unit testing. We'll be testing the component in the individual wise or in the module wise. Next, we'll be moving forward to the integration testing. That is, we'll be integrating all the unit tested components in the design phase. Next, we'll be moving to the validation testing. Here, we'll be validating whether the accepted requirement is the actual requirement than compared to the expected output. Next comes to the system testing. Here, overall system elements has been tested. So this is the testing strategy. It has been given in the spiral form. Next one is test strategies for conventional software. First of all, we can have the unit testing. In unit testing, it focuses on the unit wise, that is component wise or the module wise. Here, it mainly focuses on the internal processing logic or the data structure within the code. So we can have five types of consideration. First one is module interface. That is, we need to consider whether the modules have been interacting with each other, have been correctly interfacing with each other. Next one is local data structure, whether the data has been assigned correctly, whether it maintains its integrity. Next one is independent paths we need to check. That is, in a statement, in a source code, we need to consider all the statements in all the independent paths in the control structure, whether it has been exercised correctly. And then fourth one is boundary conditions we need to check in the loop statements. And then finally, all the error handling paths have been tested. So these are the five types of consideration in the unit testing. This is the pictorial representation of what I have said earlier, that is, test cases will be there that should be written in the form of five types of consideration. The first one is module interface, second one is local data structures, third one is boundary conditions, fourth one is independent paths, fifth one is error handling paths. These all being corresponding to a given module. Next one is unit test procedures. How we are going to do the unit test? This is the pictorial representation of doing the unit test. This has been given in the environment. First of all, I'll tell the right side part, that is the test cases. It has been given with the five types of consideration as we saw earlier in the diagram. It has been given to a important component that is called as a driver. It is a main program. From that main program, really, whatever the module we are going to test, that will be called. Then from the module one, we can have the another component called as the step. Step is the subordinate module. So whenever we need to test our current module, we cannot test as it is. We just want to have the main module from where it has been called. And also we just want to have the subordinate modules from this module. What are the subordinate modules are there? So these are the representation of the unit test environment. So first of all, we need to consider the driver and the step software. Then driver is the main program and steps is the subordinate program. So unit testing, it will be simplified whenever it have the cohesion is being designed. What is called as a cohesion? Only one function is being there in the component. It is very easy to test that function, and also we can identify the errors and also we can uncover the more errors. So these are the unit test procedures. Next one is integration testing. That is, next type of testing is the integration testing. Here it is a systematic technique for integrating all the components. So whatever we have done previously, that is unit testing, we need to take the unit tested components, we need to integrate it and we need to test it. That is the integration testing. Here we can have two approaches. One is non-incremental testing, second one is incremental testing. So this is the pictorial representation of integration testing approach. In non-incrementation testing, we can have big bang approach. In incremental integration, we can have four types of testing, that is top-down testing, bottom-up integration, regression testing, and last one is smoke testing. First one is big bang integration testing. In big bang integration testing, all the components or the modules will be integrated together and it has been tested as a whole. That is, when you consider the picture, in the system we can have six modules. Six modules have been integrated simultaneously and also it should be tested together. Next one is top-down integration. Top-down integration is an incremental approach. Here we can have the modules have been integrated by moving towards the hierarchy. That is, we can have two types of integration. One is depth-first integration. Second one is breadth-first integration. In depth-first integration, we can have majority control path. That is, how many paths have been coming as a depth first integration. Next one is breadth first integration, means it incorporates all the components that is being subordinate at each level and also it moves across the structure horizontally. That is, whenever we consider the M1 as a module, as the three modules, M2, M3 and M4. Then in M2, we can have two modules, M5 and M6. In M5, we can have one module, that is M8. When we see the depth first integration, we can integrate the modules in the form of M1, M2, M5 and M8. Okay. When we consider the breadth first, we can integrate the module in the form of M1, M2, M3 and M4. First level, we need to complete it. Then comes to the second level, that is M5, M6 and M7. Then third level is M8. This is the top-down integration. Here, we need to follow some of the steps. That is, first of all, we need to consider the main control module as a driver. The steps to be substituted for all the components that are directly subordinate to the main control module. Then depending on this selection, that is the approach has been selected, the subordinate steps have been replaced with the actual components. So after completing all the tests, again we need to replace the step with the real components. At last we can conduct the regression testing. Okay, so when you see in this picture, first of all, M1 will be acting as a control module, that is driver. Then we can have M2, M3, M4 act as a steps. Then after completion of M2 and M3, it has been converted back to the modules, that is M2 and M3. But M4, it has not been converted to a module. It has been shown as a step in the inclined line format. Similarly, M7 also has not been converted to a module. It is being shown as a step. So this is the top-down approach. Next, we can have the bottom-up integration. What is called as a bottom-up integration? We just want to start with the atomic modules. What is called as atomic module? We just want to start at the lower level in the program structure. We just want to move towards the upper level. That is the bottom-up integration. Here, while seeing the pictorial representation, here at the bottom level, that boxes have been shown as in the form of a clusters, cluster 1, cluster 2, and cluster 3. So, lower level components has to be compiled in the form of clusters. Then, they have to be integrated into a driver. Then, third step is we need to test the clusters. After testing the cluster, after that, this cluster will be integrating directly to the module, that is MA. So only it has been shown in the inclined form, that is not the final one. It has been the intermediate form. For testing the cluster, we need to put the drivers in between the modules and the clusters, that is the D1 and D2. After completing the D1, we need to go for the D2, that is after testing the cluster 2, D2 will be removed. That cluster 2 will be directly compiled with MA. And then in cluster 3, after testing the cluster 3, it will be going to the D3. Then D3 will be removed. Then cluster 3 will be directly integrated to MB. Then MA and MB will be integrated directly to MC. So this is the approach we are following in the bottom-up integration. Next topic is regression testing. Regression testing is whenever a new change comes to a software product, already we have built some of the integrated components have been tested, that is being in place. Now the new change is coming to the software product. What we need to do? We need to do the regression testing. That is, we can accept a new control logic and also the new data path will be exercised and new input output may occur. So what happens here, we need to re-execute some subset of the test cases in order to ensure whether the change does not affect the already executed components and also it should not affect the unintended behavior. That is, whatever the behavior it has been running, it should not affect it. That is called as the regression testing. So we can do it by using the automated capture or playback tools. Regression test suite will be there. It is the subset of tests to be executed. We can have three classes of test cases. One is the sample of the test that we exercise all the software function. Next one is we need to ensure the software function which is likely to be changed, that which is affected by the change, should be focused. That is the additional test we can have. Next one is whatever the software components need to be checked. Change that test also we can add. These are the three classes of test cases. Next one is smoke testing. Smoke testing is also the integration testing approach. It has been commonly used whenever the product is being developed. And why the name is called smoke testing? Whenever we are doing the testing in the first time, we should not catch the fire or the smoke. So that name is called as the smoke testing. It basically focus on the important functions to be tested in the form of the build. What is called as a build? We need to translate our code, that is, we need to integrate our software components which has been translated into code earlier, that is, been integrated into a build. That build contains all the data files, libraries, reusable modules, and a series of tests is being designed to expose the errors that will keep the build from properly functioning, performing its function, and build is integrated with the other builds in order to ensure whether the smoke testing is being conducted daily. So some of the benefits of smoke testing is quality of the end product is being improved, and also integration of the integration risk will be reduced, and the errors is being simplified, and also correction is being made easily, and the progress is being easier to assess in the form. Next one is validation testing. Validation testing means we just want to have the integrated software is being tested based on the requirements. It is being based on the requirements to ensure whether the desired product is being obtained or not. That is, it describes a validation criteria selection, that is validation test criteria. After each validation test case has been conducted, one of the conditions exists. First condition is function or the performance characteristics have been according to the specification. Second one is any deviation is there in the specification that should be undiscovered, and also deviation deficiency list should be created. Next thing is in validation testing is configuration review. Intent of this review is to ensure that all the elements of the software has been properly developed, has been cataloged, and also have the necessary details to support the activities. Next, the third form of validation testing is the acceptance testing. Acceptance testing is to ensure whether the software works correctly in the actual work environment. Types of acceptance testing are alpha test and beta test. Alpha test is being conducted at the developer side by some of the representative group of end users, and it is being conducted in a controlled environment. What is the advantage of alpha test? Means users who are testing the environment, they can get an easier training in using the new system, and also the acceptance of the system can be immediately known to the developers, and problems can be easily identified and fixed immediately before delivery. And what about the disadvantages? It is being conducted in the testing environment or the lab environment, but not the real life environment. Functionality cannot be tested as a software because still it is being in the development stage. Next one is beta test. Beta test is being conducted at one or more end user sites or the customer sites. They need to verify all the problems and report to the developers at the regular intervals. And advantages is quality program. Quality is being improved to the customer feedback, and also security loopholes. Loopholes means ambiguity can be identified by the customer. Then any training requirement can be identified. Disadvantages is finding right beta tester and maintaining its participation can be a real challenge. And this can be management. This cannot be a management because beta testing is conducted in the actual work environment. Thank you.